7:24 now. Thanksgiving obviously is just a day away, but if you don't have your turkey yet, perhaps it's nothing to worry about, and you may actually get a break. Some stores have an abundance of turkeys this year thanks to a rise in the number of part-time turkey farmers. Who knew?
I know.
Anyway, grocers discount the birds to draw, customers in for other necessities. So in my demented way of thinking, in other words, it could pay to procrastinate because you get your turkey cheaper.
As for the day after Thanksgiving, many of us are skipping the crowds. We're going online to do our holiday shopping. So for that story and more business news, here's Chris Valerio live at the New York Stock Exchange. Good morning.
Good morning, Deirdre. You know, guys, I knew there were more turkeys in this world now. I'm just kidding. All right, while some of us will be at the mall on Friday, more of us are actually going to go shopping online. Internet retail spending rose 17% for the first half of November compared with a year ago. That is according to research firm ComScore. And online holiday spending is predicted to increase 20% for the final 2 months of the year. Now, we do have a report just out on consumer confidence that I want to mention real quickly. The University of Michigan says that consumer confidence actually fell to a two-year low in November, and that is, of course, as those fuel costs increase and also as the housing market deteriorated. Well, the global sell-off is extending into U.S. markets this morning. That's after stocks in Asia and in Europe fell following Fed comments yesterday about a lowered outlook for U.S. economic growth. Also, got to mention crude oil futures this morning hovering near $100 a barrel, trading right now at $97.39. So take a look at how all this news is affecting the major averages. We do have red arrows across the board. The Dow actually down triple digits, down 116 points. Meantime, the S&P 500 and the Nasdaq both down at least 1%. Freddie Mac getting more attention today. Analysts say the nation's second largest mortgage lender may need to raise $6 billion to replace required reserves that have diminished because of mortgage-related costs. And shares of Freddie Mac taking a hit again today, down 3%. Also, got a price war in the fast food business that may be coming your way. The Wall Street Journal says Burger King plans to start testing a $1 double cheeseburger. The paper says Burger King plans to offer a larger double cheeseburger than McDonald's does. Double cheeseburger is one of McDonald's best-selling items, by the way. So there you have it. Live at the New York Stock Exchange, I'm Chris Valerio, Bloomberg News for KCRA 3. Chris and Deirdre, so when you run out of turkey, you now have more double cheeseburgers to look forward to.
I think that's a good thing. And cheaper as well. That's a very good thing.
Thanks, Chris.